this here on the from our side to the left was Benjamin Halevi. He was the president of the District Court of Jerusalem, and this was Judge Rave, the district court judge from Tel Aviv, from the District Court of Tel Aviv. He was one of the witnesses who at that moment gave evidence. This was Eichmann himself, sitting here between as a sort of protective glass cage. Here was a defense counsel, Dr. Savatius. That on that day here was Mr. Hausner, the Attorney General, one of the police officers who took part in the investigation. This was myself, and this was Dr. Robinson, who the historian, who sat there with the prosecution, although he did not take an active part in the case. This was the whole of the prosecution team. This was the Attorney General, Mr. Hausner. That was myself. This was Mr. Bao, the district attorney of Tel Aviv, one of the police officer, and this is again the historian, Dr. Yaakov Robinson, who also wrote that book on the book of Hannah Arendt.
Who do we have here?
Well, this is myself in the middle. This is Dieter Weschenbuch, one of the younger defense counsel, and this was also a member of the prosecution team who prepared some of the legal arguments. This was a picture taken just a few months ago, when I visited Munich. There was a congress held in Nuremberg called Judging Nuremberg, where I was asked to give a lecture on the Eichmann trial, and where also the former prosecutor in the Nuremberg trials, Mr. Wendy Harris, took part, and Mr. Ferenczi, who was in charge of the Einsatzgruppen, of the group of SS men who killed people by shooting. He gave evidence. I mean, the three of us, and there were hundreds of people present from all over the world testifying to the development of international law after the Nuremberg trials. And then Mr. Weschenbuch, who lives in Munich, he invited me to his home, and we went together. He showed me the area and his home, and actually we had a very close friendship also during the trial, and we've kept it up now as well.
Was this
so
the first
we met again after 45 years. We hadn't met for 45 years. We hadn't met at all, only by telephone sometimes.
Yeah.
Yes, this was a picture taken in Nuremberg during this conference. This is Mr. Wendy Harris, the deputy prosecutor in of the American prosecution, the deputy of Mr. Jackson, who was the main prosecutor, and he was the number two. And this is myself, and this is the president of Touro University from America. And actually, the two of us, Mr. Harris and myself, we visited together the Dachau concentration camp. So this was actually when I questioned the first witness in the trial. This is myself, Mr. Hausner, the Attorney General, and Defense Counsel, Dr. Savatius. This was during a trial itself. This was Eichmann and the two wardens at his side, and that was myself, Mr. Hausner, Dr. Savatius, and another member of the prosecution assistants. That was not a posed picture. That was taken, I remember, it was the only witness, and I think the only person in the world who was already in the gas chamber and could tell the story. He described how, as a child, he was taken into the gas chamber. There were 200 children in that gas chamber. And he described how they at first, when it was getting dark, how they sang to give themselves courage. And then, when nothing happened, they began to cry. And then the doors opened, And it transpired that they had a train load had arrived with potatoes, and there were not enough SS men to unload it. So the officer there had the glorious idea, why not take some of the children inside there before they were killed to testify, to take one of the children to help in unloading the train. And they did. So the first 20 were taken out, and he was one of those, and the others were killed. And then he described how the others were also killed, but they said that he'd committed some negligence, it caused some damage to one of the trucks, so he was sent to the camp to be flogged before being killed. And the SS man who had to carry out the flogging took a liking to him and kept him as his batman. This is how he managed to escape. And after, I mean, there were lots of cruel things during the trial, but even for the Eichmann trial, that was something special. So the, from the point of view of the cruelty and the shock, so after that, the judges decided to have a break of 15 minutes. And at that moment, I was that picture was taken of me, and also one of those things that are difficult to forget. That is yes, picture here. This is Dr. Savatius and the other, the Dr. Dieter Weichenbruch, and here one sees the Attorney General and myself. That is a picture of Eichmann himself during one of these sort of typical gestures. And this was taken in the actually courtroom of the where the Nuremberg trials were held, and where my wife and myself were standing next to the place where the accused Göring and Hess and all the others at Keitel, where all they were sitting. This is a picture where the American prosecutor in the Nuremberg trials, Mr. Windy Harris, and myself are just entering the Dachau concentration camp.
This was taken in the summer of 05.
Yes, this was in July 2005.
It was commemorating the 60th anniversary of the Nuremberg trial.
Yes, yeah. Exactly.
Thanks.
Thanks again to Skip Paul for the grant administered by the Maytemkin Fund at the University of Wisconsin Law School, and also to Dan Carmi, the videographer in Tel Aviv, Jiminy Productions is his company, and to Michael Sullivan here at the University of Wisconsin for his extraordinary technical assistance.
The crash of the head. the crash of the heavens, the prayer of the heart.
Yeah.